surgery day is a long day. It's actually longer for the parents than it is for the patients. Everybody is required generally to be on the third floor, the inpatient unit, at least 3 hours before their surgery is scheduled to start. About 2 hours before the surgeon actually starts the surgery, the nurse on the floor will give the patient something to help them relax, either a pill or liquid, depending on the patient's preference. And then over the course of the next 30 minutes, the patient and their family will move downstairs into what's called the holding area. And there's a nurse there that will sign them in and ask a lot of questions. Oftentimes, a member of the surgery team will come by, and if they haven't already, they'll sign the patient's back where the incision is going to be made. And the anesthesiologist will come and obtain a consent from the patient or from the parents. And then eventually, all the paperwork and computer work will be done, and they'll be ready to what we call roll back to the operating room. From the time the family kisses their child goodbye to the time where the surgery actually starts is usually 45 minutes, anywhere from 30 minutes to an hour. So you're kind of prepared for surgery and push off, but it's really 2 hours before the surgery starts. Preparation involves making sure that everybody that your child sees on a regular basis is aware that they're going to have a major spine operation. So if you have a cardiologist, you'll be asked to go back to the cardiologist. If you see the pulmonologist, or if you have a history of sleep apnea or severe asthma, you may be asked to see one of our pulmonologists beforehand. Many patients will see the developmental pediatricians. Almost all patients will see the dietitians or the nutritionists to ensure that their nutrition is appropriate prior to surgery. Depending on the neuromuscular diagnosis, it's probably important to make sure that they have good oral hygiene and that their oropharynx and all their teeth are in good condition. They don't have any problems with their teeth. And those are things that all happen probably 2 to 4 months before the surgery. And a lot of times, even before you have a surgery date, you want to make sure all of these people check off and say it's okay. And then we'll find a date on the surgery schedule for you. Surgery for neuromuscular scoliosis, depending on the diagnosis and the length of the surgery, usually it'll take about 6 hours. Could be an hour or two shorter, could be significantly longer than that, again, depending on the complexity of it. Then they'll usually be in 306 until they're breathing on their own and they're eating on their own, and their pain is controlled with oral pain medicine. Many patients with neuromuscular scoliosis will use BiPAP, and even if they don't have that at home, they may have it for a few days after surgery. And that's essentially, it looks like a jet fighter mask that's strapped onto the face, and it looks terribly uncomfortable. The interesting thing is if you need the oxygen, you don't fight the mask. And so patients actually tolerate the BiPAP mask incredibly well. And again, for many patients, that may be present for the first 2 or 3 nights after surgery, and sometimes even during the day. One of the big concerns for patients with neuromuscular scoliosis is ensuring that we get the nutrition started. A lot of these patients will have a G-tube ahead of time, but even then we'll have to start slowly on that, but get them back up to their normal calories. And then the other thing that we're very cautious with patients with neuromuscular scoliosis is the wound. These patients have an increased risk of infection. Probably about 1 in 10 will develop a deep infection around the spine implants. So your surgeon may have a very specific routine addressed at how they want the wound dressed and what they keep on the wound and how they use the drain coming out of the wound and all these efforts in the first week or two to make sure that we do everything we can to avoid a deep infection. One of the things that's really important is to make sure that these patients go home with the appropriate equipment and that the equipment fits their new body. And so most patients will have their chair and their wheelchair pressure mapped prior to discharge, and to make sure that they're in a chair that is comfortable and not going to cause problems for them, and that any other durable medical equipment that they need to look after the child, whether that's a lift or a bedside commode or whatever things the family needs, are provided for them. The recovery from posterior spine fusion for neuromuscular scoliosis is really pretty variable. I've had patients back to school half days in 2 weeks, and I've had patients that really aren't sleeping normally for 6 months. So a lot of it depends on the underlying diagnosis and really the extent of the curve beforehand. And a probably good rule of thumb is how hard was the acute postoperative phase. I mean, the patients who are in the hospital 3 or 4 days are probably going to bounce back and get into their normal routine more quickly than the patients who are in the hospital for 2 or 3 weeks.